While most family stories involve blood relatives, others revolve around a sisterhood, like the one here on the square in Jefferson that was born out of a tragic loss.
Long before Jefferson had a bell tower, its downtown had the Centennial.
It's been here 146 years.
A building on their square's corner.
It started as a bank.
That even stood out back in 1907.
There are 61 faces on this building.
The 61 ladies looking down from every ornate window. But 3 years ago, drops fell from their cheeks when February pipes burst, drowning the restaurant inside.
We had 44,000 gallons of water come through the building.
It was just devastating.
To every business on the square.
They felt the impact when the restaurant went away.
In plenty of towns, neighbors had asked, who'll step up? In Jefferson, Peg Rainey asked,
what if we got 30 women to put $5,000 together and we could renovate this building?
In a few months, she had an army of $5,000 contributors outnumbering the ladies on those windows, all asking,
why shouldn't it be a bunch of women from Jefferson saying, why not us?
That question,
why not us? We can do it,
kept coming up. None had construction experience, but that,
why not us? Why wait for somebody else to step in and do something?
Became their name and the women's mission.
We all have a common goal, and our goal was to save this beautiful old girl here.
While also,
that is a chicken tetrazzini.
Supporting a woman.
That is a honey-infused goat cheese.
Who dreamed of being a chef here since she grew up down the street.
This one is a cookies and cream cheesecake.
A dream made possible by 68 women.
I always joke that these ladies could run the world. I mean, they...
who invested in a sister and their hometown.
I think, I don't know, it is overwhelming when you think these women probably are not going to get a return on their investment, but they just have this incredible belief in this town and this building and me, and it's pretty incredible.
Jefferson Centennial.
It is the most significant thing I've ever been involved in.
Opens in just a few weeks.
It's a project of love.